Hello children, I am going to tell you how you can create tables in OpenOffice database. So this is the software of OpenOffice. I have just opened it. Click on the database tab here. Okay, it is asking what do you want to do? Create a new database or open an existing database file? So here we are going to create a new database. So it is already selected. Right, click on next, then click on the finish. Now we have to give the name for the new database that we are going to create here. Let us suppose I am creating school database. Then click on the save button. Now this interface will come. Here we have different database objects like tables, queries, forms, reports. Now we are going to create tables. Two options are provided us: create table in design view and use wizard to create tables. We will use these two options one by one. First we will create table in design view. So click on this option. Right. Field name is the column name. We are going to create table, right? So field name is the column name. So let us suppose I am taking roll number, field type means what kind of data you want to insert in that particular field. So roll number will be of number type. So here I am taking number. Second, student name, I'm taking S name. This is text type. Text data will contains the text, alphabets, letters, right? Then next, I'm taking marks. Okay, again number. So I have taken three column names. Field means column. I have taken three field name or three column name, and I have specified the data type. In the description box, you can write about the columns, like what is roll number, about something about the roll number or the student name and marks. It's optional, so better to avoid this. There is no need to fill this column. Here, you can make roll number column as a primary key. You know what is primary key? Primary key is a unique column in a particular table. So, and we give primary key to differentiate among the records. So if you want to make roll number as the primary key, right click here and click on primary key. Okay. Simply save this. It is asking for the table name. I can give the name student table. Okay. And then close this. Now here you can see student table has come. Double click on this. See, this is the student table. Now we will fill the data inside the student table. Roll number one, student name, Neha. Marks 89, Rohan marks 56, then so here I have inserted three records in the table. Click on the file tab and then save the current record. You also save it by using the control plus S key and then close this. Now you can see this is our student table. When you will double click on the student table, this is your student table. Okay, close. Second way to create the table is use wizard to create table. Click on this. See. From here we can choose the different categories, like business category is given here, personal is given here. Click on the personal. Let us suppose I am clicking on this and I am choosing maybe accounts. Okay, accounts I am taking. Then here I am choosing the names, account name, account number, account type. Here I have taken three fields, right? Click on the next. Now, next we have set field types and formats. Here we can change the name of the fields as well as we can change the field type also if we want. Right, instead of account number I can write student ID. Student ID, field type, we can also change the field type. So here I am taking number. Okay, then account number, instead of account number I can take another, I can take, it is up to us. If we want to change the fields, we can change the fields. Father name. Okay, text type. And then in this, I am taking the address. Text type. Click on next. Right. Now it is asking, create a primary key. Automatically add a primary key. If I'll click on auto value, that one column will be added automatically. Okay, having automatic values. If I want that some column from the table should become the primary key, then I'll click on this. So I'm clicking on this and I'm making student ID as the primary key. Okay. Then click on next. Now, I have to give the name to the table. So here I'm giving student data. And click on the finish. This is my table. Now we can insert data, father's name. Okay, from here you can insert the data. I'm giving you two examples. Okay, I have saved two records in the table. Click on the save, Control S, and then click on the close tab, close button. Option, right? So here we have got two tables, student table and student data table and student table, right? Okay, next we can do, we can also change the data after inserting data, right? How you can change the data? See, I'm opening, I have opened this. If I want to change the father's name, what I'll have to do, just click on the column. Okay, just click on that particular cell. Now from here, click on the text tab. Now I can change the name. Okay, in this way you can change the data, right? In this way you can change any record in the table, right? And if you want to delete any data, what you will have to, if you want to delete any record, what you will have to do, just click on that particular record, right click here, right click, and then click on delete rows option. Do you want to delete the selected data? Yes. Okay, so in this way you can delete the record from the table And again, I told you how you can insert. Just simply click on that and you can insert the data in the table. Okay. So here I can insert the data. Okay, I told you about the primary key. That primary key is the column in the table that contains unique data. So if I try to insert the duplicate data, what will happen? See, okay, when I'm going to the next record, it is showing me error message. Why? Because I am violating the constraint. I am in primary key, I am inserting the duplicate value. So this is showing it. It is not letting me enter the next record. So what you will have to do, you will have to make it 3. Now after this, when you will try to insert the next data, it will take the next data. Okay, so this is the advantage of primary key. If you are making any column as a primary key, it will not let you enter the duplicate data. Understood? Okay, from here I will save that and I will close this. Okay, so there are some properties that I want to show you. If you want to edit the properties, this is student ID, numeric type, father's name, text, where, care, address. So see, these are the properties. Entry required, no. Here entry required is no. If I'll make it yes, then you cannot leave that particular column vacant. Aap is column ko, father's name column ko vacant nahin chhod sakte, khali nahin chhod sakte. Aapko iske andar name fill karna hi padega. And by default, it is no. Okay, length is 50. If I'll make it 10, then it will take only 10 characters, right? It will take only 10 characters. I'm showing you this. If I'm making it, let us suppose I'm making it 5. Father's name, I'm making 5. Okay, and entry required, I have written yes. Okay, and default name. Default value means the value that will come before inserting any other value. Default value एक ऐसी value जो अपने आप आएगी उसके अंदर, आप उसमें insert नहीं करेंगे तब भी आएगी, ठीक है? तो अगर पहले मैं आपको ये दो field show करती हूँ, entry required मैंने yes कर दिया है और length मैंने कर दिया character की 5, and I am going to save this, save as yes table 1. This is yes, of course this is table 1, not save as, we have to click on the save. Should the column state be deleted and the new format appended? Okay. Okay. Fine. Because we have given entry required as yes, so it is asking us to create a new table. Okay, we are creating a new table, right? Because we have ये यहाँ पे हमारा error message इसलिए आया है क्योंकि हमने already उसमें entries कर रखी हैं और यहाँ पे हमने length दे दी 5, right? तो हमारी ये new table बनेगी, right? Then close. देखो ये हमारी table 1 new table insert हो गई है. अब इसमें 1, अब आपने father's name में 5 characters का दिया है कि you will insert only 5 characters. तो if I'll insert, see Ram, it is taking Ram. Okay, address it is taking, right? In the same way, if I'm making it larger than this, okay, and then okay, when I'll go to the next record, you will see error message will come. Why? Kyunki yahan pe maine kya diya hua hai, father's column mein number of characters should be 5. Okay, and entry should be, so if I'll make it short like Rohan Rohan, then it will go to the next record. You can see, then it will go to the next record. Okay, Now it is going to the next record. Fine. And if I leave it vacant, अगर मैं इस कॉलम को vacant छोड़ती हूँ क्योंकि मैंने entry required yes कर दिया है, तो भी क्या आएगा, मेरे पास error message आएगा. You can see. See, again error message because मैंने इस कॉलम को क्या कर दिया है, vacant छोड़ दिया. इसमें आपको entry करनी ही है. Right? And then close. Now, okay. Entry required हमने किया था yes. By default ये no होता है. अगर आपका entry required no है तो you can also leave it vacant. आप column को vacant छोड़ सकते हो. And अगर if ये yes है, entry required is yes, then you cannot leave it vacant. Length by default 10 होती है, 10 characters. मैंने इसको क्या कर दिया था, 5. ओके. एंड डिफॉल्ट, डिफॉल्ट क्या होता है, डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू होती है वो जो बाय डिफॉल्ट आती है, अपने आप आती है. बाय डिफॉल्ट में लेट अस सपोज आई एम गिविंग वन नेम अमित, राइट, एंड देन आई एम क्लोजिंग दिस, सेव एंड देन क्लोज. यस, नाउ यू कैन सी द टेबल. व्हेन यू विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट रिकॉर्ड, सी अमित इज कमिंग बाय डिफॉल्ट, अमित. ओके, आप इसके जगह पे कुछ और भी दे सकते हो, एनी नेम, ए बी सी डी, वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू गिव. देन सी अमित इज कमिंग बाय डिफॉल्ट, राइट, बिकॉज आई हैव गिवन अमित इन द डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू, राइट. अगेन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एडिट एनीथिंग, सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू दीज प्रॉपर्टीज. If I'm inserting date column in this, so date of birth DOB, हम इसको DOB ले लेते हैं. Okay, and then the format will be date type. Now in date type, from format example we can take the different formats here. It is coming. See the different formats are here. आप यहाँ से कोई भी फॉर्मेट चूज कर सकते हैं, जो भी फॉर्मेट आप अपना लेना चाहते हैं, राइट, लाइक दिस और समथिंग लाइक दिस. 31st December 1999, फ्रॉम हेयर यू हैव चूजन योर फॉर्मेट. फाइन, so this is your DOB. You can see when you will insert you can see it has changed according to the format that I have taken, I have chosen, right? So it has changed. आपने डेट इंसर्ट की और उसने वो फॉर्मेट अकॉर्डिंग, जो भी हमने फॉर्मेट चूज किया था उसके अकॉर्डिंग वो चेंज हो गई है, राइट. सो दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द टेबल. ओके, length, decimal places. See, for the text we have the properties entry required, length, default value and format. Okay, again for the date we have same properties, so you can change these properties according to your requirement, right. So in this class we have done how we can create table in the OpenOffice database, right, how we can insert the data inside the tables. In the next class we will do queries and forms. Okay, bye bye.